Amsterdam calling, so pick up.
So welcome everybody to Artis-Micropia, the first and only microbe museum in the world. And today on the National Poop Day, fully about poo and what poo can do for you. The cool thing is that half of your poo consists of microbes, so bacteria, fungi, yeast, and they're there for a reason, and they have a lot of health benefits, and those stories are the ones that we're going to tell today, partly in our Tour of Poo, which is a special route throughout the museum where you learn more about your intestinal microbiota, but also during several different expert talks about poo. Part is that your intestines are completely filled with microbes, so billions and trillions of microbes that even outnumber your own body cells. So most of those microbes live in your intestines. Makes it that your poo, which is, well, at least half microbes, is one of the most interesting places to go look for new medicine and new ideas of how we function ourselves. An entire wall of poo. A lot of animals from artists from the zoo donated to Micropia to show them their excrements. As you can see, a lot of differences between the different animals, purely because they have such different diets. But the same goes for humans. I mean, we're omnivores, so we eat both plant material but also animal material. And often when you eat more vegetables, you have a more diverse and a more stable intestinal flora. And that's what you really need to keep healthy.
Hello, my name is REMCO KORT and I'm connected to the Micropia Museum here as a professor. Over the last years I've been investigating bacteria in the feces of Ugandan children, and what I'm specifically looking for is if we can identify bacteria in the gut of these children that enable them to bind and degrade toxins. And these toxins, they're produced specifically in this part of the world as a result of the humidity and the hot climate. And as a result of that, these children have a strong growth impairment, but also it impairs cognitive development. So it's a very important issue. And what I hope is to isolate these bacteria. And in the long term, we hope to develop a starter culture for fermentation of local food with it, so that we can also think of an intervention with these bacteria.
A special part of this route is the new addition to the museum, our new exhibit about how we transform elephant dung into a plant feed using very special microbes. So as you can see here, we have the different steps from, as you can see, the quite obvious elephant dung. After we add the microbes and some special minerals, it almost looks like soil, really. And all the herbs and vegetables that we cultivate in the elephant garden go back to the animals in the zoo. We kind of complete the circle, and then the elephants poo it out again and we make new so-called Bokashi.
Bokashi is the fermentation process of organic waste. You put on microbes, anaerobic microbes, to ferment the organic waste. We are in the Zoo of Artis, and the Zoo of Artis has one big major organic material, and that is elephant dung. We're gonna fill the bucket with elephant dung. We're gonna spray it in with microbes, effective microbes. Then we will put on some minerals. Then the bucket is full. It has to be in the bucket for 6 to 8 weeks, and then the product is ready to improve your soil at home.
This is the end of the Tour de Poop in Micropia. Thank you for joining us. As you've now probably learned, is that your poo is actually much more than the stinky brown stuff that you flush down the toilet every day. But there's a huge invisible realm that's very important to your health. So take care of your intestines, take care of your microbes, and that way you take care of your own health.